to this last video in the series of us making DIY postcards together. I'm making mine for the swap that I host, and in this video I will show you all of the finished postcards in the end of the video. But first I need to finish my last couple of postcards by making marks. I'm bringing out my blue Posca pen because I've been doing blue postcards lately. It's not really a color that I've used a lot, but I really enjoyed making these postcards. Posca pens are great. They are filled with a liquid acrylic paint, and if you haven't tried that kind of pen to doodle on top of your acrylic paint, I really suggest you give them a try. And then I'm just going to be continuing mark making. Adding pencil, crayons, and even painting with my fingers. I fear nothing when I'm making postcards. I just jump in and try to make something that I think is pretty. I would love to know what you think of these postcards in the comments below, or if you are joining the Postcard Swap this year. I've hosted it for 10 years and I'm really excited because there are so many who are signing up this time. And I want to thank everyone who's signing up. It's really fun to see your names pop up, and I love seeing your postcards when you're sharing them on blogs that I might be reading, or that I hope that you're sending me links to them, or on Instagram where we have a hashtag that's been diluted lately with a lot of other people using the hashtag, so we might switch and just use iHanna's Postcard Swap this year. But it's a lot more postcards under the hashtag DIY Postcard Swap because I've been using it for, like I said, 10 years. I thought this postcard was done, but I guess not. It was a little bit too blue, so I'm adding a bit of crayon marks and a little bit more color. I'm a big fan of the monochromatic look actually, but it can be boring, so I tend to add in at least some other color. And these are the ones I've been working on so far. Blue turquoise postcards, and then some more colorful ones that have been born since I last saw you in my last video. And actually I'm not done with the second layer on this postcard, so I'm adding in just more paint. I didn't think that the first layer was actually, I don't know, I don't want to say good enough, but covering enough. So I went in with some more paint and more marks. This cloud, I've already posted the finished product of this cloud, who actually became a little commercial for the DIY Postcard Swap. So you can watch it. I will link all the playlists and the individual videos in this series, as well as the blog post where I've linked to products and other blog posts I've written before with stuff that might be inspiring or interesting to you. I'm not really thinking about color theory when I'm making postcards. I find theory of that kind rather boring, but now that I watched this video I remember that yellow is the complementary color of blue, so it just might be the reason why I reached for the neon yellow and added it in. And of course blue and yellow makes a wonderful green color, so it's just fitting that all the colors go together in a way, and as the theory says, they complement each other. They're like making a statement, I think. Maybe you'll notice things like this too when you're like looking at your work once it's done. I'm not really consciously planning or thinking out what will look good together. I just let it happen, and usually it turns out into something nice. This is a crayon that is inside a marker. It's called the Dilato, and it's like a oil-based crayon that is really smudgy. I got a package of 3 or 4 a couple of years ago that are in the warm tones, but this is my favorite, this neon pink one. It's so yummy. And because this seems to be turning into a rainbow, I bring in some more paint. This is called magenta, quinacridone magenta, and it's one of the few golden paints I have, a little bit more expensive than my usual go-tos that are like cheaper brands. I don't really think it matters much what kind of brands you're using when you're making things like this. The most important thing is that you have experimented with them. Some acrylic paints are really covering and some are really transparent. So these postcards are done, I think. I'm going to be sorting my crayons, my crayon bits into the box and moving them aside, and ta-da! I think I'm actually done with making postcards for this time. I have a pre-printable, which if you've seen the series, you already know. It does not have the label. I'm blocking it off here so that you can see that it's not on that printable, because it has my name and email and stuff like that. So I don't have to write it out every time I'm finishing the postcards. I think it's important to always include the swap name or whatever kind of postcard sharing you're doing, because some people are in a lot of different ones, so they might not know where the postcard is originated if you're not saying so on the back. And a lot of people I know are really hoping that you're including your full name and your email on the backside of your postcard so that they can send you a thank you note. I stress oftentimes on my blog and to worried people that it's not required to include your email if you don't want to people to send you a thank you note. But it's very appreciated, and it's appreciated that you acknowledge that you got a postcard. Just send a quick, "I got your beautiful postcard, thank you." That's enough. And it eases a lot of worried minds, because it happens that postcards get lost in the mail. It's really, really sad, and in these times, I don't know how this swap will end up. Because there are actually countries that say please don't send mail right now. In Sweden, we have been hearing that post is essential. And I hope all of the postcards I send out will reach the recipients. And I hope that the ones that they send out will reach those that are on their address list. But who knows? We'll just have to cross our fingers and hope for the best. And if there are any problems, please let me know. So these are my finished postcards. I hope you have enjoyed this series of mark making, mixed media, layering, DIY postcard fun. I have had fun, really enjoyed this series of postcards. They turned out quite similar to the ones I did last year, even though I didn't look at those. They're on my blog if you want to see them. And I'm loving the postcards. I always take photos so you can see them individually on my blog, in case you want to have a closer look at any of them. And thank you so much. Lots of love and metta to you. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do so and hit the bell so that you will be notified. At the end of the video, I'll include some clips from my Instagram and Snapchat. Thanks for watching. Bye.